Nandalal is always interested in the common man's way of life. So the postcard belongs to everybody. So he opts for the postcard and he paints them and he sends them. It's the cheapest form of communication. It's the way he would use the cheapest material when he did the Horipura Congress. He didn't want expensive material. This idea that we do away with the luxury and that art becomes affordable, you can make it with the simplest, that is part of the ethos of Shantiniketan. I like to say it also becomes part of the ethos of the postcard writing. You travel, you sketch, and you send it out.
I think sometime in the 1950s, would be 52, 53, I was about 9 or 10 years old at that time. My grandfather took me to Nandalal Bose's place, and there was this, Nandalal Bose, he didn't look very much like an artist, you know, in that sense of the term. He was there, he was sitting in his, as far as I remember, he was wearing a kurta and a lungi, and he was sitting there. And it was a very kind of a genial atmosphere. He, sketched something on a card for me, gave it to me. And my grandfather said, you'd better, take care of this. There's a sketch of my grandfather by Nandalal Bose, where he says that this is your grandfather, Ramesh Charan Bose. And he is not just a teacher, but he is also an artist. Even today it's very difficult to become a professional artist. And because these people were there, Shantiniketan was there, because Avanindranath was there in Jorashanko and at the Calcutta School of Arts and Crafts, it is because of this ambience that people who were not actually depending for their livelihood on painting, even such people in those difficult times could still cherish and nurture what they loved. He had a 3 feet by 2 feet, a wooden box, a beautiful wooden box with a sliding lid, and he used to keep his paper, his some of his paintings, his scribbles, his brushes, his paint boxes, all these used to be kept in this box. It comes at a time when my grandfather, Ramesh Charan Bose Mojumdar, is really becoming more and more involved in his profession as a teacher and in his family life and so on. But he has the same what we call wanderlust. He has been to many different places. He has wandered around himself, but now he is unable to do this. But his friend has not left him. His friend is coming back to him through these postcards and saying that look, if you can't come with us, then look at these through my eyes.
From the postcards, we know of all the places Nandalal is traveling. We know of professional worlds coming together, of notes being shared from Tokyo, where he's going with Rabindranath in 24. From Bar. It's interesting to me to learn about a friendship that moves between the private and the public domain, between a personal levels of bonding and a professional circle. And the times were extraordinary, that the 20s, 30s and 40s is the time when you're traveling the most, discovering India. It's also the time of Nandalal's close equation with Gandhi and Gandhi nationalism. Gandhi is an avid writer of postcards himself. So this time and some of the places tell us, Faizpur, Haripura, Porbandar, Dwarika Kathiawad, he's in Gujarat, and he's in Gujarat as part of his engagement with Gandhi and the Congress. So it's a very important moment again in Nandalal's own career, and but also in the career, in the history of modern India. DAG may have a much larger collection in this exhibition, apart from Nandalal books, so in order of the way in which they'll appear, Abhinendranath Tagore, Oshit Kumar Haldar, Jamini Rai.
What is really wonderful, something that the process of which we shall never know, in between there's so many, you know, shiftings, there was the partition. And even all through that, these postcards must have been with my grandfather. I can tell you that they were not in that wooden box. Maybe he had, even at that time, he had given it in safekeeping to my mother. But we never knew about it, where my mother had kept them. In her last couple of years, my mother also had dementia, so that she was unable to tell us about this collection. I mean, otherwise I'm sure she would have told us about it. So we were just after her death, we were rummaging through her almira, we were cleaning it up. And then suddenly there was this packet wrapped up in plastic. When I opened it, we couldn't turn our eyes away from them.
And very recently, at the time when the family rediscovering this collection of Nandalal Bose's letters, this building is ready and our archives reopen here, and then collections come in. But the fact that Malinidhi thought of us as a place to house this collection, we are really honored, and we hope we can do justice to the trust.
If my grandfather was living, or if my parents were living, if my mother was living, this is what they would have wanted, that it should go somewhere where it would be in public view. Art lovers could come, where research scholars could come. And I'm very happy that the center, they have been able to move in a direction where this might be possible, where new generations, they can see these pictures, they can read these letters, and they can understand what sort of heritage we have, what sort of country we live in, how rich we are in this heritage. We would like everybody to understand this, and that's why we are all very happy that you have been able to do this. Thank you.